Hi there, and I'm very sure just like me, you're getting super bored at home. And just like me, you cannot wait to travel again. So this is what I'm doing while waiting. I'm deciding which are those places I want to go once the lockdown is over. And when I checked with my friends, a lot of them told me about these heritage stays. So here is the list of heritage stays near Kolkata that you must absolutely check out.
About 100 years ago, when Bengal was still undivided, you could find gorgeous mansions and rajbaris all around. In recent years, about 100 of those in West Bengal have been restored and made into heritage stays. If you are a history buff or looking for a fitting style holiday or just want that royal looking cover picture or even looking for a destination wedding, these are the places to check out. And of course, the royal feeling would be incomplete without the meal fit for royalty. So most of these places also provide the most incredible dishes. After all, what is being a Bengali without the love for food? So here's our pick for the best heritage stays in Bengal. Barikoti in Murshidabad, Amedpur Rajbari in Bardhaman, Mohishadal Rajbari in East Midnapur, Rajbari Bawali in South Chobbish Pargona, Itachuna Rajbari in Hooghly, Jhargram Palace in Jhargram District, Koshimbazar Rajbari in Murshidabad, and Maheshganj Estate in Nodia. A 6 hours drive from Kolkata and you reach the beautiful palace set amidst the regal backdrop of Murshidabad Barikoti Mansion, which has a mix of Greek, Roman and French architecture, was owned by the Dudhoria Raj family of Azimganj in late 1700s. This heritage hotel boasts of the renowned Sherwali heritage, traditional way of life and cuisine. Set beside the majestic Bhagirathi River, this invites you to take a grand stroll along the ghat, sipping a cocktail. You can also relish a hot and sumptuous lunch on a boat or enjoy the finest tea by the riverside while a beautiful flute plays in the background. On your visit, you can also check out the vibrant culture of historical elements that Murshidabad has to offer. Murshidabad stands for its 250-year-old terracotta temples, Hajarduari Palace of 1000 doors, local markets, Imambara Palace, Futi Mosque and Katra Mosque all will transport you back in time. To carry back some of the royal charm, you would find the best quality silk and muslins in Tatipara village and Islampur. Barikoti provides accommodation in luxurious suites with traditionally decorated interiors and furnished in antique decor. There are 15 luxurious heritage suites categorized as heritage suites, royal heritage suites and Maharaja heritage suites. The Rajbari also arranges for Baul and Fakiri music and Rai Veshe dance for its visitors to enjoy the evening. Amodpur Rajbari. Amodpur lies in memory under Bardhaman district, is just 2 hours drive from Kolkata. Amodpur Rajbari is a classical Jomidar mansion. The Borobari of the Chaudhuris is one of those heritage stays you should not miss. Along with the hospitality of the Zamindar's family in their 375-year-old estate, you will also enjoy the 550-year-old terracotta temple surrounded by the lush greenery. You can visit the Nishikanto Ashram, tomb of Narahari Baba, ghat of 350-year-old and Durgabari and other terracotta temples. You can visit the Nishanko Ashram, tomb of Narahari Baba, the ghat, a 350-year-old Durgabari and other terracotta temples. High ceilings, ancient furniture, lovely verandas all bring alive the zamindar in you. For more adventurous, the lakes become natural pools for a refreshing dip under an evergreen cover. Along with the Borobari, there is also the Boitokkhana, Dolmoncho and the Shiv Temple. The Amedpur Rajbari has been celebrating Durga Pujo, Kali Pujo, Dol Jatra in the traditional way since generations. Relish the traditional Bengali cuisine cooked in a typically home-cooked way with authentic masalas. The most popular dishes are posto bora, shukto and labra with fish. Mutton and chicken and local mishti doi are also a must. This palace provides you an authentic experience, so no AC or geyser. If you need hot water, you will be provided a nice steaming bucket of it. Do not expect bright fancy lights. Instead, you can enjoy the evening lamps and a bonfire with the locals. The experience is something you won't have in other heritage stays. The Ahmadpur Rajbari offers 4 spacious rooms with attached washrooms. With room tariff ranging from 2,500 to ₹5,000 inclusive of breakfast for twin occupancy. Mahishadal Rajbari. Instead of taking the Delhi highway, if you take the Mumbai highway and drive for about 3 hours, you would reach the Mahishadal Rajbari in East Midnapur close to Haldia. It is also known as the Phoolbagh. The businessman named Janardhan Upadhyay Garg from Rajasthan once established his jamindari back in 16th century. The old palace is in its ruins and the present one was built in 18th century by the then Maharani. It has 2 palaces, the courthouse, the Kachari, the Naburatna temple and a ghat. This place is a favorite with movie makers and have been used in many movies over the ages. The ground floor is now converted into a museum with old weapons, antique furnitures, Belgium glassware, some stuffed animals that Rajas had hunted and some other documents. 2 of the rooms with attached toilets have been well decorated and given to the visitors. The place can be well connected with your trip to Gadiyara and Gaokhali. It is famous for its Jagannath Ratha Yatra and Durga Pujo, both more than 200 years old. Many films have been shot here. You can also visit the Lal Koti, the Ramas, Dodhi Bahun Temple, the Modon Gopal Temple while you stay here. There is a twin sharing room costing around 4,000 and another room having 6 bed costing around 7,000 per night excluding taxes but including breakfast. The ground floor is now converted into a museum with old weapons, antique furnitures, Belgium glassware, some stuffed animals that Rajas had hunted and some other documents. 2 of the rooms with attached toilets have been well decorated and given to the visitors. The place can be well connected with your trip to Gadiyara and Gaokhali. It is famous for its Jagannath Ratha Yatra and Durga Pujo, both more than 200 years old. Many films have been shot here. You can also visit the Lal Koti, the Ramas, Dodhi Bahun Temple, the Modon Gopal Temple while you stay here. There is a twin sharing room costing around 4,000 and another room having 6 bed costing around 7,000 per night excluding taxes but including breakfast. Located quite close to the city of Kolkata is a small village of Bawali in Bajbaj, South 24 Parganas. It takes about an hour or so to reach here from Kolkata. The Rajbari itself dates back to 1700 and is now being run as a heritage hotel. The Rajbari building is a great piece of architecture and very well maintained. The heritage property once belonged to the Mondol family, one of the zamindars of Bengal. It is now owned by Mr. Rawla, who undertook through renovation and turned the mansion into a heritage hotel. The architectural grandeur of the building, an impressive dining area and heritage items add to the experience of the royal and indulgent past of Bengal. Cultural programs are held in a fascinating courtyard. The terrace of the palace is something you must visit. Accommodation is provided in 30 different rooms and suites classified in classic heritage, notunbari, zamindari suite, royal suit and dak bungalow with elegant wooden furnitures to enjoy a royal stay. Approximate charges are varying in range around ₹6,000 to ₹15,000. Breakfast is included with free Wi-Fi, parking and 24 hours room service. You can also join in activities like having a pleasant spa, a cool swim in the pool, having a fun ride on the bicycle or have a walk in the surrounding small villages. Itachuna Rajbari. Moving a little further away at about 85 kilometers from Kolkata in the village of Pandua stands the grand Itachuna Rajbari. Built in 1766, the place also known as Borgidanga, located barely 2.5 hours from Kolkata. The Itachuna Rajbari is a well-maintained Rajbari that has now been transformed into a heritage stay. There is a temple adjoining the compound and daily aarti is performed. This 200 years old magnificent palace is divided into 5 mahals, namely the village courthouse, a dancing hall, a cooking arena, a otithi shala and an andor mahal. The front courtyard is huge with ornamental light poles. With the addition of the mud houses at the backyard, the ambience has now interestingly changed. One must not miss the huge terrace from one end to the other. Have witnessed quite a few groups singing at few different places over the roof without any disturbing noise from each other. The rooms are named interestingly using traditional joint family relations like Borda, Boro Bodhi, Choto Bodhi, Boro Pishi, Kaka Babu, Jatha Moshai. The mud huts are named after different flowers like Konoklata, Madhubilata, Jhumkolata, Aparajita, etc. The room, the entire mansion, the very wide balcony, all are furnished with antique furniture and artifacts. In ground floor, there is an extra large chessboard for display. The king-size wooden cots in the rooms are unique and make sure you sleep like a king or queen. In fact, in some rooms, you need to climb a few steps just to get into the bed. You will be served with Gondhuraj Lebu Sharbat on arrival as welcome drink. The elaborate Bengali lunch is served in traditional style in Kashar Thala, that is bronze in English. One can do a lot here to spend time like playing table tennis, chess or fishing in the pond, barbecue in the evening, etc. On the way back, one must see the Pandua Tower and the Terracotta Temple of Devipur. Price range for the rooms varies from ₹1500 to ₹8400. Wi-Fi is available with doctor's facility for any emergency. The Jhargram Palace is located around 175 km from Kolkata and it's a 4-hour drive. Its nearest railway station is Jhargram itself. Jhargram is a homogeneous mixture of nature, culture, tradition and heritage. Jhargram Raj was established around 1592 by Sarveshwar Singh, who along with his younger brother were generals under Man Singh of Amer and came to Bengal to conquer. They defeated the Mal rulers and tribal rulers of Bengal. Emperor Akbar as a reward granted Shubedari of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa to Man Singh. They adopted the surname Mollodeb and set up his kingdom with Jhargram as its capital. In 1799, the Jhargram people revolted against the East India Company along with the rulers of Bishnupur and others, which history recorded as Chuhar Mutiny. Jhargram has a long history of at least 400 years. Cutting it short, Naroshingho Mollodeb remodeled and developed Jhargram into a modern planned township in 1931, spread over 30 acres of land. The descendants have now tied up with West Bengal Tourist Development Corporation to open the place up for tourists. The fully air-conditioned ground floor of the Rajbari complex offer a grand, comfortable royal stay to the visitors. The rooms are classified from Classic Deluxe, Family Deluxe, Premium Deluxe to Royal Suites. There are 30 various rooms for the visitors. While at Jhargram, one must visit the Chilkigarh Rajbari, the Konak Durga Temple, the Dulung River, the Medicinal Plant Garden, the Belpahari and the Lodhashuli Forest Area. Kashimbazar Rajbari. Kashimbazar is in Murshidabad, located about 200 km away from Kolkata and will take about 6 hours to reach by road. It can be a scenic drive but can get bumpy at places too. Otherwise, one can also go by train to Behrampur and then it's 10 minutes away. The Rajbari of the Roys was built by a notable merchant of silk export in 1748 during the reign of Aliwardi Khan. Murshidabad was then the capital of Bangla, Bihar and Orissa. After being shut for several years, the family renovated and restored the palace in the early 90s. The palace was also rebuilt and extended a bit. After renovation, they converted some of the rooms into guest rooms and some have been converted into a museum with antique furniture to animal trophies. The bedroom, central ballroom and the dining room are perfect blend of European and Indian architecture. The dining rooms have an incredible 20 feet long dining table. While staying there, one must love to see the ancient factories, the Durga Mandir, the Radha Govinda Mandir. October to March is the best time to visit when the families hold the annual ritual at the Chondi Mandap. Also, it's worth visiting the Shobha Ghar, the Malkhana, the Clock Tower, the Radha Govinda Mandir, the Lakshmi Mandir, the Ashutosh Shivnath Mandir. There are various bedrooms designated as the King Suite, the Deluxe Queen Suite, the Executive Suite, which consists of a traditional high Victorian bed along with the cloths rack, an old-fashioned dressing table. You must also see the traditional hand-pulled fans of that time. Tariff of the rooms usually around Rs 10,000 plus taxes on twin sharing basis. The Maheshganj Estate. The Maheshganj Estate Balakhana in Nadia district is 200 years old mansion. It is about 125 kilometers from Kolkata by Durgapur Expressway. After crossing few stretches of bumpy road. Also, it is about 12 kilometers from Krishnanagar station. It was widely known as the Indigo House, Neelkuti, as it was owned by an Italian indigo planter. In 1977, indigo plantation was introduced by the then East India Company, which later turned into a major revenue earner due to huge demand of dye in Europe. In 1860, by a court order, forced indigo plantation was stopped. Later, the mansion was bought by a family of the Pal Chaudhuris in 1875, one of the Bengali landlords. Present owner is Ranodhir Pal Chaudhuri. Situated near the Jolongi River, it is a 16 acres property with one of the best heritage stays of West Bengal and also ranks as one of the best in India. There are four rooms for the guest and the charge was around Rs 4000 with complimentary breakfast. The lunch and dinner are extra to pay for. The hospitality and the food will make you feel really special. The Zamindar family still often stays at this estate, dedicating a portion of it to heritage lovers. Their presence makes sure you will get the best of your tour. It's a no-smoking property. It also has a playroom where you can try your hands on billiards or table tennis board.